morning, everyone. Welcome to our first workshop. It's the first of the workshops we'll be having in the course ACE 811-911. I assure you that it's going to be a very successful day, like the others that we've been having. And being a workshop, we'll try to make it as interactive as we can, and then we will break it into two. We're going to have the T-test first, and then the ANOVA session. So it's a two-hour interesting call. So let me begin by sharing my screen with you. So again, I welcome you. Welcome you to today, Saturday, April 25, 2020. The program of work for today, which will run from 9 to about 11, is that you're going to have a short welcome. That's what you're having now. And we'll go on immediately to have the live practical session on T-test by Professor Anthony Kola Olusoya, Deputy Vice Chancellor of Osun State University. And then we will be interacting as we go along here, because it's expected to be a workshop and it's a practical session. And we will have question and answer after that. And then we'll take on the ANOVA segment. We will have the live practical session, and then we'll have question and answer, and then we'll close. Let's welcome our facilitator. Who is our facilitator for today? It's no other than Professor Anthony Kola Olusoya, a professor of environmental sustainability and presently the Deputy Vice Chancellor Academic Research, Innovation, and Partnerships, ARIP, at Osun State University. He received his PhD from the University of Toronto in Canada. His research and teaching interests include environmental impact assessment, human dimensions of environmental problems, sustainable development, resources and environmental management, indigenous environmental practices and management, and climate change and conflict. Climate change. That's Michael Mike there. He's also interested in qualitative methodological approaches to social and educational research. He also teaches research methods and statistics at both undergraduate and postgraduate levels. He has published in both local and international learning journals and has contributions in books. He was a visiting scholar at the Center for Environmental Philosophy, University of North Texas in 2013. He's also an associate expert at UNESCO Institute for African Culture and International Understanding at the Center for Human Security of the Olusegun Obasanjo Presidential Library. It's my pleasure to welcome, can see him smiling, great scholar, great university administrator, Professor Anthony Kola Olusoya.
I'm so pleased to join this class this morning. I don't know how his son will come before the father or come back home to tell stories. I don't know. But all I know is that I am prostrated now, because everything I'm going to talk about, I can't do it sitting down nor standing up. Even though you might see me sitting down, my spirit is laying prostrated on the floor, because I have been taking through journey of life to understand that difficult problems are actually not difficult, but they are simple. It's also a question of the way the difficult problems are presented to us. I happen to have come from a background that one of those, would I say, lazy students who was told in the secondary school by one of the youth coppers then at the Ibadan Grammar School, who called me a blockhead because I couldn't recite a formula. And he said, "You're a blockhead."
Wow.
I think I remember her name very well. She's Miss Maideribe.
Hmm.
I've not met her since then, but she called me a blockhead. And since that day, I told her, okay, I'm a blockhead. I'm not interested in math. I don't even care. By the time I got to Lagos State University, my life became like that kind of person that met on the way to Damascus, met the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit I met in this time around was Professor Peter Okebukola, distinguished Professor Peter Okebukola, who told us in the class that, look, there's nothing in this world that you cannot conquer. Even the most difficult formula, you can conquer. And I told myself, all right, tell me more. And then it went on and on and on. At the end of the class, I went home, I told myself, I'm not sure I want to take this course. What is a compulsory course? What do? I just have to read and pass. But you see, going around through the class, all through the semester, I discovered that I was never a blockhead. I wasn't. It was just a label. That the fear that I got from secondary school got taken away from me by the distinguished professor. In a very simple manner, he brought statistics to me in a manner that I felt like, oh my God, so this is this chick. And that sunk into me from that day onward. And I swore that day that I would do everything to be able to pass this knowledge to generations that I will meet as long as I live.
Wonderful.
And I can tell you that when I joined Osun State University, most of the students were running from statistics class back in 2009. And I told them in social science that, look, this is not difficult. I could make students be interested. And then the provost of the college said, okay, take it. It's yours. And then I divided the class. Who are those that are afraid of arithmetic? I separated them. Who are those that are afraid of mathematics? I separated them. Then, who are those that are interested? I separated them. I moved those who are afraid to the front of the class. And from there, we went on.
Wow.
At the end of the first semester, and when the results came out, and I said, look, I don't base my conclusions on results. This is one thing I learned from the Western education system. You don't just go by results. You just go by how students are able to comprehend. And I ask questions. And I see that a student may not get the final answer,
sure,
but they got the steps.
Sure, that's it.
To me, that was achievement.
Sure.
And since then, I stuck there. And I told myself, I won't depart from the gospel of St. Peter Okebukola that I learned back in the 90s, 80s and 90s, and I'll continue it for as long as I live.
Thank you very much.
I move away from Damascus. I am here now. I don't even know where I am, but I am preaching the word, and the word continues. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are in this class and you come on with a fear or you're confused, like you see on the screen, you don't know which way to go, there is only one way, only one, and that's the way ahead of you. St. Peter Okebukola's way. That's the only way. Take it simply. It looks complex, but it's simplified. At the end of it all, you'll be surprised where you'll be.
Thank you very much, Tony. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Like every student, we come into statistics class confused. You can see, what do I want to do? What do I want to learn? What have I to gain from this? Is there no other secret way of just getting by this thing? And then, you know, in these days of miracle exam centers or miracle workers, oh, yes, we can get it by. You're confused. But don't be confused. This class is going to help you work through the whole system. And you find out that at the end of the day, when Nigeria or the whole world is calling for statistics, especially at this period when the president of the United States, Donald Trump, is having problem with statistics and science. You can step forward and say, I'm an African.
Yes.
We have the solution.
Yeah, of course.
So at the end of this class, I expect you to be able to mention the advantages of parametric statistics, identify the differences of when to use the t-test and ANOVA, mention the assumptions, demonstrate how to calculate t-tests using SPSS, and demonstrate how to calculate one-way ANOVA using SPSS. Okay, now, the moon. What does this mean? We are all moons.
Hmm.
We have our bright side and we have our dark side.
Sure.
The dark side, we don't want to show anybody. And that is the confused side of us. Nobody wants to be asking questions. What is 1 + 1? And if you don't know it, you don't want to say it. You just say, That's your dark side. But on the bright side, it looks like this. And then you are learning forward. What are parametrics tests? Why is this guy going parametric test? I'm talking Hanover, we're talking T-test. What has this got to do with us? But you see, the basis must be established.
Sure.
Where you must start from. These two test apparatus are parametric tests. And they are used only when distributions are normal, as assumed. But you see, the beauty of this world is that both of them are used in most common times. They have their advantages. Yeah, you're looking for trustworthy results when the groups have different amounts of variability. Parametric tests is your mess, it's your miracle. And if you go away from there, you move further. You look at the differences, because in life, there's nothing that has commonalities that don't have differences.
Correct.
Just like, I'm a man, or I'm a male. Professor Onche Ezewe is female. Is she a scholar? Yes. Is she a researcher? Yes. But she's female. That's the adjective defining her. So, the differences we're looking at here is well established. You know, T-test is used when determining whether two averages are the same. And then you look at Hanover. But, you know, I'm just doing this so we know where we are going. This is not the journey. What do you see? For those of us in Africa today, with the exception of those who probably are in the diaspora that's outside of African continent, we may not be familiar with the tales by moonlight. You know, I showed you the moon in the beginning.
Sure.
Now I'm showing you tales by moonlight. You see the old man with his car and children, you know, that's the way statistics is. When you gather everybody, Professor Peter Okebukola called all of us, we were about 70 in those days. I jump into the class, and then he said, I want to teach you statistics. Okay, thank you, sir. It was like tales by moonlight. But, you know, tales by moonlight graduates from what you don't know through suspense to where you will end, and then you will find your eureka. Let me leave the eureka moment for now. T-test. This was developed exactly, if we say 101 years old today, we're correct. If we say 102 years old, we are also correct. Something was significant 108 years or 101 years ago. I mean, 102 years or 101 years ago. That was the period W.S. Gossett, who wrote under the name Student. You know, sometimes when you want to risk your life, you don't want to appear that you are the one in case you make mistake. So Gossett came under the name Gossett. I mean, Students. What happened that period, 1918, when it came about with this statistical approach, there was pandemic. That was the period we were talking about, the flu pandemic that we still deal with today. It was at that period called the Spanish flu. Across the world, 35 to 50 million lives perished. And then, this is Africa. How does this concern us? Yes, it does. It was colonial period. Nigeria had people traveling from outside the country coming in. 500,000 Nigerians perished in that flu pandemic. And this is probably why this period, I mean, if you don't want to sink this in, tell yourself that I'm learning these statistics at a period where there's need for me to apply it to solve African problems.
All right.
As we go on. And this is where we are. It's still relevant. 100 years plus is here. And we don't have 500,000 lives lost yet. But we just have to be careful. This is where we are. What is a T-test? It's a type of inferential statistics used to determine if there is a significant difference between the means of two groups, which may be related in certain features. I tell you, a T-test, like other statistics, has its assumptions, but I'm not going to dwell on that yet. It also tells us how significant differences between groups are. In other words, it lets us to know if those differences measured in means or averages could have happened by chance. No, when you say by chance, it's like saying my gut feelings. I woke up this morning on the right side of my bed and I asked myself, do I normally wake up on the right side? Of course not. So why did I wake up on the right side? It must be chance. Why is the reason for the chance? Because I was thinking about this class all through the night. Either two, I would wake up on the left side of my bed. Because why? The left side of my bed, I can easily put my leg across the bed and I slip it into the slippers and I walk out of the bed and my day begins. That's the way. So it's not happening by chance. So that's the way we look at it. And you know, a T-test also look at the T-distribution values. These are issues that we must think about when we're looking at T-tests. But you see, you can't really go on except you also understand sometimes. You know, when we're writing our project and we do the proposal and they will say definition of terms. Why do we need definition of terms? Because you also want your reader or your supervisor to be able to understand where you are going and where you're coming from. Also in statistics, we have those terms. In T-test, we have the T-score, which is a ratio. And then we have the T-values. You know, the T-test is different between two groups, and the difference between the two groups. You can look at it further in the small icon. A large T-score tells you with the groups that are different. And a small T-score tells you the groups that are similar. It still looks like, what's Tony Olusanya talking about? Okay, he wants to do miracle. No, I'm not. I'm just following what I was taught. You know, like you and like every one of us. I've had to traverse this landscape called life, or some people call it earth, but I call it experience, and I can join it together. I call it life experience because I've been privileged to be mounted on the shoulder of giants, and those giants, they piloted me through life. And the biggest giant, when a baby is carried by many strangers, the baby just says, wah, and it stops. But when the mother carries the baby don't cry anymore. There was a giant that I stuck on his back and his shoulder. St. Peter Okebukola, distinguished professor. I refused. Everybody stretched their hands. I told them, look, I'm not following your way, and I won't, and I will just stay on this path. And that was it. And because I stayed on that path, I continued to ask myself, if this man, who is far older than me, don't sleep 24 hours, don't rest, 3 hours. It keep moving. What will be my motivation to have a siesta and sleep? What will be my motivation not to find out what is advancing? This is why I have moved on. And this is why when you are defining your terms, it helps you to define who you are. Like we're saying now, every T value has a P value to go with it. It's like saying every Anthony Kola Olusoya has a Peter Okebu Kola to go with it. Straightforward. And then a P value is the probability that the results from your sample data occurred by chance. I won't go into the story of how myself and Professor Peter Okebu Kola consummated, or I consummated the relationship that we have today. Maybe at the end of the class, I will tell you. But not now. Let me go on. Main types. There are two types of t-test. The independent sample t-test, and this compares the means of two groups. And the second one is the paired sample t-test. It compares the means from same group at different times, say 1 year apart. What do I mean by 1 year apart? You know, sometimes we do studies, and this study, we call it longitudinal study.
Sure.
It goes more than a year. So a paired sample t-test would help you in this manner to compare the means at different times. Because, okay, like we've done it for 1 year, that's 2019. We're doing it in 2020, and we are concluding the study in 2021. What is different? That is what a paired sample t-test helps us to do. It compares the mean, and we are where we are. How do you now tell yourself? You know, this goes beyond gut feelings now. You can't just sleep and wake up on the right side of the left side of your bed and tell yourself, okay, I'm going by t-test, or which kind of t-test to use. If you look at the diagram up here, or the picture, or the figure, whichever way you call it, determining the correct t-test to use. The first one is, are the two sample sets same or related? If your answer is yes, then you are going for the pair-dependent t-test. But supposing your answer is no, you move to the next one. Are the two sample sets of the same size? If your answer is yes, you go for equal variance, that's independent t-test. Now, don't be confused. It's just the way it is. Supposing the answer is no, do these two samples have the same variances? If your answer is yes, you still go for equal variance, that's the independent t-test. I know very well that in our advanced statistical class, we are already familiar with what a sample is. We're familiar, and we're also familiar with what the variance is. But supposing the variance now says no, what you do on equal variance, independent t-test. That's how you find your way out. It's like I was in the forest, and then there was no compass. And I remember when I was walking, when the dog is going for a walk, when the dog walks like a few meters, the dog stops. And you wonder what the dog is doing. The dog stopped to pee. And you ask, why is this dog peeing everywhere? The dog is putting milestones on the way. At every meter, maybe some meters, the dog will stop and pee. Not necessarily that the dog was feeling that I need to ease myself, but it was mapping its way. Just in case, you as the pilot, you got lost and the dog need to find its way home. If you get you home, after 3 years, the dog will have been known 3 years before you. Okay, because he knew his path. That's the nature of other animals. So, explaining the test. T-tests allow us to compare the average values of the two data sets and determine if they came from the same population. For example, If you were to take a student, a sample of students from class A and class B, I mean, let's go Afrocentric, like Professor Michael Over said. Lecture discussion method is the way we were taught from Almighty Mungo Park. But when we met Professor Peter Okebukola, he told us, look, Mungo has passed since. Now, he told us Mungo movement. And Mungo movement is the culture, the CCTA. And if you compare the, let's say student in class A, go by lecture method, and student in class B, go by CCTA. We are familiar with that. Then we can say we will not expect the same mean and standard deviation. Exactly. Because one is different from the other. Certainly. But mathematically speaking, t-test takes a sample from each of the two sets and establishes the problem statement by assuming a null hypothesis that the two means are equal. That's mathematically. And based on applicable formulas, certain values are calculated and compared against standard values and assume null hypothesis. Let me quickly backtrack a little bit. If you have to do your project or thesis or dissertation, or you want to go on the field, if you just say, okay, yes, Professor Peter Okebukola taught us this, and then his disciple came and told us we should go ahead and use this. And at the end of it all, and you didn't have an hypothesis,
yeah,
I tell you, you are like a car without fuel, with the engine without oil, trying to crank a start. I can tell you, you'll be just on the same spot for centuries to come.
Sure.
Because you do not have the hypothesis. Hypothesis would help you to define the way you were going to go.
Sure.
And there's always an alternate. If I say, oh, you can tell me Anthony Kola Olusoya is a male. And then I know Dr. Binka Akinkutu is on this platform today. I'm not sure she's in the class yet. But she can tell me, look, Anthony Kola Olusoya is a female. It's research to find out.
Sure.
And then she comes up with a null hypothesis, which will be alternative. You need this for you to be able to move further in statistics. After having done all this, I must tell you, just like in life, there are assumptions. For t-test, there are assumptions. Assumptions for t-test, the first one is that the scale of measurement, the assumption for a t-test is that the scale of measurements applied to the data collected follows a continuous or ordinal scale, such as scores of an IQ test. The second assumption made is that a simple random sample, that the sample is collected from a representative randomly selected portion of the total population. I know definitely because I've seen these videos online. I don't tell myself when I want to go into a new area or even known area not to go and do research. I was trying to find out a lot of things online overnight. And I discovered that Professor Peter Okebukola has actually taught this class about a lot of things. And this is a part of what we're talking about now. The data of a representative sample of a population. The third assumption is the data, when plotted, result in normal distribution, bell-shaped distribution curve. And the final assumption is that homogeneity of variance, that's homogeneous or equal. Variance exists when the standard deviations of samples are approximately equal. And now, there we are. How do you perform t-test?
We have 10 minutes, Professor Tony.
Yes, sir, I'm running.
Yeah, okay.
We can do by hand, We can do by Excel. We can do by SPSS. Okay. By hand, you see the formula. You have to cram this. You don't have a choice. You just have to cram. Let me tell you, in 1 second, Professor Okebo Kola, when he was introducing me, let me tell you, if you don't know, Professor Okebo Kola was the first in capital, FIRST, staff of Lagos State University, to own a desktop computer.
Yes.
I'm telling you history. This is biography. He's the first one. And you see, when he was trying, by the time I met him and he was trying to teach us, the formula was too much. I couldn't cope. I couldn't. You know, this was where I was. I was like a tortoise. I go the first day on Monday. I go back on Tuesday. I'm still crawling. That is what, if you have to calculate those statistics by hand, calculate this test by hand, you'll be like a tortoise. Where would you be? You know, don't forget, this was in 1918. You will be in 1818, 100 years earlier. This is the formula. You have to cram it. But you know what? Then it took me, it jumped past me into SPSS. And then I saw this. Before I start this, you know, I write the hypothesis, like I said. I determine if my test is a one-tail, then I move on to the alpha level. Oh, my God. You can see the jet cruising in the sky. That's SPSS jet. Taking us on a cruise through the sky to the solution. It means you don't have to use your brain anymore. Thanks to Bill Gates. When he came up with his own system, everything was friendly. That's why they say human-friendly computers. Stage one, you open your worksheet, you define your SPSS variables. How do you define variables? I quickly, I step to telling you this in these few slides. 1, 2, 3, you won't know. You have to define them. And then is the sample problem. You click the data. We're still defining your variables. You're still defining. Once you're done, then you come to step three. All those variables are in. You click analyze. Then click compare means. It's just that time may not permit us, but we can always continue to review this. These steps are eternal. Take it to GATT.
Wow.
Take it to Ashkelon. Take it to Palestine. Take it to Washington, D.C. Even take it inside White House. Don't worry about whether Trump is saying it's not the same. Just tell yourself it cannot change. Okay. That's the way the steps are.
Yes.
Step four is the same. Step five goes on. And step seven tells you what you will see. First level, second level. And then how you will see the result to be interpreted. And then if it is two-tail, you also see. And this is where we are. Two-tail sample set means in Excel. You can also do an Excel, but you see, Excel is just like taking DKW. My father used to have the DKW in 1950. You know, those cars that you have to wind the front before you start. And when it starts, you just keep moving there. You cannot even go beyond 10 kilometers per hour. That's what Excel is. You cannot do it. You can't do Excel. Not anymore in this period. The world is gone away from Excel and hand. We are just by cruising by plane. What are our takeaways? A t-test is the type of inferential statistics used to determine if there's a significant difference between the means of two groups, which may be related in certain features. The t-test is one of many tests used for the purpose of hypothesis testing in statistics. Underline, hypothesis testing. That is, don't go looking for any herbalist to help you or no profit. Just look for t-test.
Yes, who is coming on? Renee, you have the floor.
Yeah, Good morning, sir, and congratulations to Professor Anthony. My first question is to know what is the difference between parametric and non-parametric statistics.
All right. Thank you very much. So, Professor Tony has noted that. Who else is asking a question before I call on people to ask a question? Franklin, be ready. Be ready. Desire, you also be ready to ask a question. Let me see who else is there. Bugoma Suwadu. Baka Ramadan. You know, yesterday it was, we asked that we give greetings to all those participants who are observing Ramadan. So I'm going to call in that order. I will call Buguma will be number three. Let's see now. Franklin will be number one. And let's go on like that. Well, Franklin, you ask a question.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I just want a clear example on the paired sample. He said the paired sample is used to compare means from the same group at different time, but I would love to see like an illustration to that.
Okay.
Just like how we did for
I thought he gave that illustration. He gave you the illustration anyway, but he will answer the question. Mm-hmm. He did. Yes. Okay, let me take number two as Bugoma. Yes, Bugoma, you want to take the floor? I can see Dides, is that you?
Yes.
Yeah, you want to ask a question? Yes, let us go on. This, it being a workshop, it has to be very interactive. Yes, go ahead, Dides.
Okay, thank you for the floor. We were told that the t-test should be the one used to test the hypothesis. Is it the only one kind of test that we can use, or we can use some other tests, or is it the best one? That's what I want to know.
Wonderful.
Can we rely always on that?
Yeah, okay, wonderful. That's very good.
Thank you
very much, Dides. Did I pronounce your name correctly? Is it Dides?
Yes, this is Dides.
Dides, oh, Dides. Wonderful, wonderful.
What is a French name?
Oh, yes, okay, that's fine. Francoise, yes. You want to ask a question? I can see your hand up. Yes, Francoise, please ask a question.
Yes, thank you very much, sir. I want to the Professor Anthony to explain again how to determine the correct t-test to use.
Okay.
If we have a lot of men to you can use, how to determine the first of the very important.
Yeah, I agree with you. That's very important. I mean, you have a story that's going on. How do you determine? And there are two groups or two times. So how do you determine which one to use? Yes, that's very correct. Although he did mention, he will repeat that. So Bugoma, are you there? Okay, she's not ready yet. Tokumbo, I can see your hand up, and then I see one other hand up. Let's go. Yeah, take the floor, Tokumbo. Okay, Tokumba is not ready. Let's somebody
thank
else.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, go ahead, yes.
Yes, sir. Please, I just thank you very much, sir, for the presentation, sir. Please, I just want him to please tell us what are the procedures for testing our hypothesis. How do we test the hypothesis? Because we mentioned of hypothesis testing. So what are the procedures, sir? Thank you, sir.
Procedures for hypothesis testing, okay. By the way, Tokumbo, there's no N in that word. It's not hypothesis. It's hypothesis. Hypothesis. There's no N there. Thank you. Yeah, I can see a hand up. That's, please take the floor. I saw a hand up just now. Yes, go ahead. Yes, go ahead. Take the floor.
Thank you, sir. I'd like to ask Professor Anthony about...
Yes, looks as if you are freezing. All right, let somebody else come on now. Let's see.
David.
Okay, David. David, take the floor. David, take the floor. David, take the floor.
Yeah, T-test want us to compare two names from two groups.
Yeah.
Or in the same groups.
Sure.
What about now is a size sample in the case of two different groups and in the same group, we know that the sample must be the same. What about the size in the two cases?
Okay. That is very good, David. Well done, David. DRC, David. Wonderful. Let's take one last one on the t-test component of this. I'm still scrolling looking for who is asking the question. Oh, I can see our technical director there, Akintunde. You have to put on your video so we'll see you. Is it because your deputy vice chancellor is here? That's why you are showing up today. Is it because the deputy vice chancellor is coming to give deputy vice chancellor your technical support? But that's a great deputy vice chancellor that you are seeing there. And all of you, please make a note. All of you make a note that this 2020, by God's special grace, just by God's special grace, 2021 or 2022. This man will, his deputy vice chancellor, DVC, that D will drop off and he'll be vice chancellor of a federal university. I'm telling you that by God's special grace. Yes, and he's going to be addressing you in one of your sessions. So let me yield to him, to Professor Tony Kola-Lusaya, for your response to the, just a minute now, for your response to the questions. You have the floor, Professor.
Yes, sir. And everybody hear me?
Yeah, loud and clear.
Yes, sir. Thanks, sir. Because some of these things, questions were fading off on my side, but I got a few. The difference between parametric and non-parametric tests. This is simple. Parametric tests assume an underlying statistical distribution in data. This is so straightforward. When you look at non-parametric, they do not rely on any distribution. And this applied when parametric test conditions of validity are not met. So it's, even though we're asking question verbal statistics, the way where we are today, it's your system that will solve all these kind of things for you once you decide that, okay, this is a parametric test. And the parametric test, you know what they are from your data. And the class from Professor Peter Okepukola earlier, where you talk about inferential and categorical data. So you know those ones that would fit in, and that would determine where you are going. Is the test the only one? Of course not. You will get to a point when you use the t-test, and you can also find out that, okay, researching further, you may find out that what is applicable is what we call the z-test. But that's not the focus in this class.
Correct.
But it's not the only one that you can use. There are various types you can use, and you get to where you're going. There are only one way or two way? No. There is also three ways for you to get to where you are going. It's, that narrow, confused path. You get to that junction, you're looking at one ahead of you, the two other peering to the other, both sides. You now decide. That's the point where, as a statistician, you have to decide, which way do I go? And what informs you is your data. The other question I got was, determining which test to use, I've dealt with that. And how do you use t-tests to deal with hypothesis procedure? If I couldn't get the name of the question, the person who raised the question, I would have asked you, and I'm asking you now in the class, to take a step backward. At the end of this class, go into your statistical textbook, and go and read the steps towards hypothesis testing. It's not something you can just take from one class and then you imagine and then you run with it. For you to be a world champion in athletics, that's 100-meter dash, you must be trained as a sprinter. And a sprinter, you could mean 200 level, you could mean 200 meters, you could mean 400 meters. But for you to be an 100 meter dash sprinter, you just have to know what you're doing. And that is why I'm charging you now. Take a step backward after this class. My email is so clear. It's on the program. You can just say, how do I, what are the procedure for testing hypothesis? And then we can take that. And if a distinguished professor deem it fit to say, look, Tony, you threw up a story here the last time. I'm bringing you back to come and teach us, facilitate how we deal with hypothesis testing. What choice do I have? All I need is just for him to call me. Even if I'm sleeping, you know, I just take it. Like I said, the first day, I just woke up. I was getting dressed. I was in the shower. My phone rang. I ran out of the shower and I said, And I said, hello, sir. He said, oh, Tony, I want you to do this. I said, consider done, sir. Because it's gospel according to St. Peter. And that is it. I don't question it. When Holy Spirit asks you to do things, don't question, just go for it. Because if he asks me to come back to tell us about the hypothesis test and the steps to go around it, take it. I'm back.
Oh, wonderful.
I'm still here.
Yeah.
I'm back. Thank you, sir.
Tony, I'm blushing already and excited. Thank you so very much. Thank you. God bless you for the honor.
Yes.
So that would be it. Joseph, how are you? That would be it. We will stop this the bit on t-test, and then we'll take on that of ANOVA. Let's appreciate our presenter, Professor Tony Kola Olusoya. Thank you very much, sir, Professor Tony DVC, for that very illuminating session.
Thank you
very much. Yes. So I need to ask you a question before I end this, Professor Tony, because what happened was that yesterday, I don't know you've seen my Statistics Made Easy series. You are making some allusion to one or two of them, Tony, because what happened was that yesterday, I just thought that I should start a series, which is called Statistics Made Easy. So I've done up to style division now, so I'll just keep going on it, to get all our data from what we have collected from the class. So, class, how many of you have watched any of the three videos uploaded yesterday? How many of you? All right, okay. So, please, the others, try to watch the video. I'll try to put one up again. I'll just keep going, maybe one per day, and you'll find them. I'm sure it will be helpful. So we'd like to thank Professor Tony Kola Olusoya again, Deputy Vice Chancellor, incoming Vice Chancellor for a federal university, I don't know what that one is, and God bless you. Bye-bye.